Good morning, everyone. It's Ripgal, playing some more Pokemon Reborn. Today, we are heading out to catch Diancie. I'm curious how this one's gonna go. We got a mission, boss. Remember Aegir Cave, where you and Bennett found the Victini? Turns out there might be more to it. There's a pretty big energy reading from somewhere deep beneath the cave. We need to go down there and check it out. You got someone? Always. The way to the cave is through the west end of Victory Road. Step forward through the new world and you're there. Once you're in the cave, I suggest looking for the lowest point possible. It might be underwater. Okay, so I think this is on this side of Victory Road. I genuinely don't remember offhand. I believe it's that little cave right here. This is the puzzle we had to do with Bennett that I totally screwed up. And here we go. Point, and it may be underwater. What's the lowest point of a flying island? That's right. This was the one that we had, like, the loop. Okay, well, that's promising at least. Okay. Is a large drop. And it's really hard to see where I'm going. Make sure there's not something else over here, quick. Alternate paths or the like. No? Never turn down extra repels. Or full restores. I mean, they're expensive. Luckily, the path is pretty linear so far. I was afraid it was going to start branching and that we're going to have to keep track of where we were going a little bit better. So I'm okay with it just being this, and I guess I'm not sure what I was expecting for items. Shards are always okay. Vitamins are just money, and the rest of the stuff is just saving us money. We have access to pretty much everything at this point. For sale. Okay, back into this. Okay. So, just a quick go over it. We're bringing, this is the special attack version of Cat. Specifically brought, throwing charcoal on, because several of the enemies we're going to be dealing with, I want to be able to do as much damage as I can with fire. Same type of thing here. However, Ryan, I'm putting in a little bit further back because there's a couple enemies that we also may need to use earth for, or ground. So that's why Ryan and Bigfella are here. Ishtar has a couple specific Pokemon to come in against. There's some fairy types that are going to be potentially using steel moves. There's one water type. So Jules RM is here as our anti-water Pokemon. And Mark. There's a few different specific Pokemon that I feel like Mark could be good against. This is gonna be two fights, so this is mostly for the general fight. The big thing is gonna be after that, though. And specifically, as you can see, I've switched Ryan over to having maxed out defense and special defense for this fight. We're going to be trying to tank a lot of hits from a very powerful Pokemon, and Ryan, we're going to be using a full-on stall strategy, which is why Ryan has leftovers as well. But that'll be after. Recognize it as one of Kane's earrings. Aw, you can't leave yet. I'm still getting your present ready. Can't you at least be patient? Didn't even have the chance to wrap it. Wouldn't hurt to show me some gratitude. Obviously, you have the entire world to strut around and they'll all pander to you and stroke your ego, because, you know, guess that's what you do with champions. You should remember who got you there. Pay no attention to the plot armor behind the curtain. Who do you think made it so you could win in the first place? You didn't have to get any critical hits. Isn't it convenient that every area you prance through just happens to have a way out? Who do you think put all those light shards around for you? I'm not saying everything you've done has been worthless. I'm just saying a little appreciation would be nice. Even this. Here I am, finding your friends, so don't forget. I've done more for you than Anna ever has. Hey, you're hideous, really. Touch me. Don't follow me. I don't know where the fight is. Wasn't a difficult request. Back off. People are ugly. You're no exception. I'm even less of one. All the commitments, expectations, personal, professional, intimate, just to live. Edness for all that. And you're still here. Do you think it's easy just running away from everyone and everything? It's easier than staying. The longer you stay, the longer people expect you to. I don't want my every action to be a decision. I just want to be, with or without others. Just let me be. As expected, you've got quite some endurance. Did you think I'd say something like that? Not like I'd blame you for expecting it if you played when I played to it so much myself. Humor is the easiest way to deflect from a serious concern. But I'm nearly spent here, so I'll ask one more time, though you obviously won't listen. Leave me alone. Even I know I can't run forever. Another full restore. Random regular Pokeball. This is exhausting. It's not like we've even gone that far. I guess that's expected. No matter how far I go, I can't outrun myself. So, you're here to drag me kicking and screaming, huh? Then make me scream, cutie. I wasn't kidding when I said people are ugly. Absolutely repulsive, every inch of them. When you stop to think about it, that's the terrifying part. That it's different when you stop to think. So I try not to think. Well, I try. Sometimes, that just makes it worse. Think about anything except pink crystals. When running from the thought, that's all there is. I learned running didn't work a long time ago, and he found me, my stepfather. I couldn't understand it. Why would my mother get remarried after already divorcing once? Why does someone like him, who snapped if we even so much as looked at him with the wrong expression? If we were late, unclean, inadequate, why him? I asked my mom once. She told me she needed him. Everyone has needs. Food, water, shelter. And although I didn't understand it until I was older, she said there was one more thing. Intimacy. And I hated that. I still do. Most of all, I hated that she was right. And I began to understand. Everyone seemed so attractive. People were cute. But when you stop to think, what's cute? When all we really are is sack of some meat and bones and electricity, my brain can make me find that cute? What the hell? It's disgusting, inside and out. People, electricity, intimacy, and me. It's all really revolting. Get it out of my sight. Get it all out of my sight. You know, these guys write... They write this type of dialogue so well. I love these characters. There's so much going on with every single one of these characters. Sandslash... Oh, we got the burn. That's even better. They do get an Aurora Veil down. That was the main thing Kat was here for, is just to take out that Marina right off the bat. Okay, well, I guess we're going straight into Jewels and hoping that we can outspeed and get this Leaf Blade in. Perfect. Critical hit. We'll take it. Mawile. That was a critical hit. Pure power. That's unfortunate. Hopefully Ryan can still... Well, actually... Yeah, let's flash cannon here. Oh my god. It's crits. They had their Aurora Veil up. That's part of what I wasn't thinking about. Okay, let's go ahead. We're going to keep Cat in and just keep burning through these steel types. Flash Cannon's boosted by the Dark Crystals, but it's not very effective. Come on. There we go. So we've got two Pokemon left to burn through. And unfortunately, they're both pretty scary, and we just lost a couple of our potential counters. Girna, huh? I mean, we could bring our own in. It's probably honestly the best plan here. Soul Heart activated. Can we take this hit? Is the big question. And I'm gonna go no. So we're gonna bring Mark in for this. Kario? Just gonna fake out. Close combat. Not fast enough. Okay. That's unfortunate. Jewels. Close combat. There we go. I don't know if we're going to get a chance to heal between this. If we don't, we might be in trouble. I had to go down. I'm glad it was... Here's to be out cold. Okay, we do get a chance to heal. I just realized I don't actually have some of what I want set up. Whoops. We'll just try this. Let's see if Groundium will do the job. Thank you. Wait, hold on. I don't like that sound. Let me try this one. Much better. Yeah, I already healed. Diancie. And Diancie has a sword. That is Crystal Aegis Slash. Custom steel fairy type with friend guard. This is also a mega Diancie. Okay. We might be... There we go. That was a really well-timed crit. The important part here is getting that Mega Diancie down as fast as possible so we can get that Aegis Slash up. So this Aegis Slash is, like I said, a steel fairy type. And it has an EV rating, or no, yeah, EV rating of over 1,000 in its hit points. So it's going to take, it's probably going to take a while to burn through this. My hope is that if we bring in Ishtar, oh, whoops, no, we want, yeah. Yeah, this is right. This is right. Okay, so yeah, we want to just start tossing flash cannons, probably, and earth powers. And it's going to use Sunsteel Strike, which is a ridiculously powerful move. If you're not familiar, Sunsteel Strike is the signature move of, oh, what is it? My brain is not saying the right words. It's the lion Pokemon from Sun Moon. Solgaleo. Yeah, let's keep flash cannoning. I want to see if I can do this close to, like, not using items, if possible. I did that in slightly the wrong order, actually. I should have swapped into Virizion because Mark could have used Fake Out to get me an extra turn. There we go. And we get a Diancie. Now, Diancie is another one that I'm not super familiar with. I think the Mega might be worth using in very specific situations, but its typing isn't amazing. It's 4 times weak to steel. And compared to a lot of the other stuff we've got. Okay, we'll get the Grisius Orb here as well. But yeah, compared to a lot of the other Pokemon, or legendary Pokemon we've got, it just doesn't hold up. Oh, there you are. I thought you were here, but when I woke up, by the way, where's here? My memory's kind of fuzzy. Say, I didn't happen to say a bunch of weird and edgy stuff, did I? That would be good. Must have been one hell of a dream then. Any dream with you, and it is. I guess I'm still wrestling with some stuff I had behind me. Not the fun kind of wrestling either. Well, there I go deflecting with jokes again, but I'll be fine. You're lost, have no doubt. No singing. Choked on Boidor or whatever it is. Okay. I'm good. All good. Where are we? Wait, what about Anna? I was just looking for her and Team Meteor. Oh, it's over, isn't it? I was really out of action for a while. I guess I should just be happy to be back. We need some time for that. What do you say we get out of here? Wherever here is, will you come with me? And for once, I'm actually going to say no. Well, yeah. No sweat. I'll find my way out somehow. It's good to be back. And the reason for that is we have one other item that I'm missing. So I'm gonna need to do a little bit of walking. Because I feel like I'm not going to want to come back. Yeah, I think it's over here. No? That's not it. No. It's supposed to be up and right from the waterfall somewhere. Like it's a top right waterfall, which I assumed would have been this. So I think this is the top of the ledge. Maybe it's before we drop, though. Oh, no. Like at the top of the waterfall, I guess? Possible. Well, I guess the only other thing I could think of is if it was down here. That's not it. Let's ride back up to the top and see if there's an item hanging out here. I bet this is it. The prison. Which I believe is going to give us access to Hoopa's alternate foods. Which, I'm not super familiar with Hoopa, but I'm suspecting might be more useful. Also get another Z-cell, which is going to give us get us one step closer to Zygarde, 50%. Zygarde 50% is interesting, though. Oh, I don't suppose I can teleport from here, can I? Can't use that. Can't use that. Well, the rest of the walks might, or the rest of the walk might be frustrating, but that's okay. We've got time. There's E-cell that I missed. So, yeah, I think I'm gonna go ahead and wrap here. We'll finish up. That should be what we've got. We'll pick back up next time, heading back to the club. And each of these chapters seems to have kind of a finale. Even though it doesn't tell you that's what it is. So the next one is going to be Jirachi. And if you recall, Jirachi is tied to the story being Anna's, one of Anna's Pokemon. So this is going to be another big one. Lots of big... I'm assuming 12v6 doubles battles, or at least 12-on-12 doubles battles with a teammate that we can't necessarily count on. So yeah. Hopefully you're still enjoying. If you are, please give me a like and subscribe. Check out the other content on my channel. If you have any questions or suggestions, please leave them in the comments. And as always, have a good one.